Hello students, looking at current affairs for 7th May, the important key words which have been picked up from today's newspaper are here, you can see. First one is that the COVID-19 virus tally in the country has crossed 50,000, means 50,000 people officially have been infected by coronavirus and number of deaths officially stand at 1,771. Second is regarding Hizbul Mujahideen's operational commander Riaz Naiku. He has been killed in an encounter presently. Before this, you should remember it was Hizbul Mujahideen commander Burhan Wani who was killed in an encounter in 2016. And since then, unrest in Jammu and Kashmir picked up. There were stone pelting incidents being seen. And even presently, after this encounter, stone pelting incidents have been seen. Police has and the administration has cut off internet in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Then next is Darbar move of Jammu and Kashmir called burden on exchequer by High Court. So Jammu and Kashmir High Court has called this Darbar move. Now what is this Darbar move? Is actually the practice in Jammu and Kashmir of shifting the capital from Srinagar to Jammu during winter months. So this Jammu is the winter capital of Jammu and Kashmir. So now it has been called a burden on the exchequer by Jammu and Kashmir High Court, and it has asked the administration to consider this point. Means administration is taking a decision based on the statement given by High Court now. And the Jammu and Kashmir political parties like National Conference, etc. have called this move as against the practice which has been going on since the Dogra monarchs of Jammu and Kashmir. And they say that this is a practice which has helped in keeping Jammu and Kashmir integrated. So, but now it seems this Darbar move would be ended. Then next is Ayushman Bharat. Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So this scheme has been in news presently. A survey has shown that in the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, majorly it is general medicine which has been availed and other conditions which can also be treated under the scheme have not been availed for. Like, you know, surgeries, etc. There have been decline in demand for that. Because as the government has also stated that only essential healthcare related ailments should be availed for, you should go to the hospital only for that. Even private hospitals are closed because of COVID-19. So that is there. So you should know in detail about this scheme, Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. It provides 5 lakh health insurance per family. And this is Boys Locker Room. Instagram group's admin arrested. So this is regarding Boys Locker Room, which is an Instagram group formed by a 12th HSC exam boy, and this is a group in which images of underage girls were shared and obscene morphed images were shared and obscene comments made. So when the screenshots of these chats came into the fore, now the admin has been arrested and all underage boys who are also involved are being questioned on this. And lastly, you have Eurozone economy forecast to contract as such. So the forecast is that Eurozone economy is going to contract, means it is not going to grow. The economy is going to go back and the growth will be at -7.7%. So now we'll look at these news items in detail too. So we have picked up the following news items from the Hindu newspaper. These are the news headlines. These 8, we'll discuss them in detail. The first one. Virus tally crosses 50,000 mark. Number of deaths surged to 1,771. So this we have already seen. Now every day the number of deaths which are being reported are in 3 digits. Like yesterday the death reported was 195 deaths in a day. And now it is 126 for 6th May. So second consecutive day India is recording deaths in 3 digits. And number of confirmed COVID-19 cases are also increasing in excess of 2,000 every day. So last figure is of 2,958. So two confirmed cases are nearing 50,000. Only 14 countries have more cases than India now. Also, central government has said that it is preparing for an increase in cases and readying railway coaches to function as COVID care centers. So railway coaches, so carriages will be deployed at 215 stations, and persons with mild symptoms would be taken to these COVID care centers. Here there will be maybe one or maximum 2 patients per carriage, and suppose that if they are, you know, they are cured, they would be released, otherwise they would be sent to hospitals. Maharashtra leads the number of confirmed cases in the country. There are 12,089 active cases in Maharashtra. Second comes Gujarat, which has 4,496 cases. Also, West Bengal has stopped counting patients who died with COVID-19. It says that if they have accompanying ailments like diabetes and health conditions, then it will not be counted as COVID-19 death. So, artificially the numbers are being kept low. So, here you can see number of cases. 39 nations have recorded at least 10,000 cases. Of them, 15, including India, have crossed 50,000 mark. And these are deaths. 35 nations have recorded at least 340 deaths. And 17, including India, have recorded more than 1,700 deaths. Then next is top Hizbul commander killed in Kashmir police. So this is terror group Hizbul Mujahideen's operational commander Riaz Naik, who was on the run for 8 years and was among the 3 militants who has been killed by the security forces in South Kashmir. And this sparked violent protests by locals in Pulwama and parts of Srinagar, forcing authorities to snap internet and calling facilities in the valley. So this is a precautionary measure being taken. And he had joined the militant ranks in 2012. He was actually a teacher and conducting coaching classes till 2010-11 before joining militancy in 2012. And he was a close associate of Burhan Wani too, former Hizbul Mujahideen commander, who was killed in an encounter in 2016. Then next is Darbar move fosters unity in Jammu and Kashmir, says National Conference. So the political party from Jammu and Kashmir, National Conference, has pitched for continuation of the Darbar move, which is a biannual shifting of the capital of Jammu and Kashmir between Jammu and Srinagar. So High Court called it burden on the exchequer and wants it to be discontinued, and the administration should take a call on that. It is a 148-year-old practice introduced by Dogra monarch to escape the harsh winters in Kashmir Valley. So in Srinagar, it is in winters are harsh, so capital is shifted to Jammu in winters. So Jammu is the winter capital. So 6 months Jammu is the capital and then 6 months Srinagar. So the National Conference Party as such is saying that this is not Jammu and Kashmir is not a unique case in India to have two capitals. Rather, Andhra Pradesh recently proposed 3 capital cities. So why is it being called a burden on the exchequer? Because anyway, it's a union territory. So here you can see these are the two capitals. So from November to April during the winter months, Jammu and Kashmir, Jammu is the winter capital. Then Srinagar. So this results in shifting. The offices have to be moved. So 33% of 10 officials, whichever is less of every office is moved. So 52 offices are moved. Then thousands of government documents are transported in 200 trucks. Then 15,000 is paid as travel allowance to every employee. And 2,000 plus rooms are booked in 79 hotels in Srinagar. So this is the Darbar move. Introduced, you can see, by Maharaja Ranbir Singh of Jammu and Kashmir 145 years ago. Then next is, hacker sees security flaws in Arogya Setu. So the Arogya Setu, which is coronavirus tracking app of Indian government, there are security flaws in it, is being highlighted by ethical hacker Robert Baptiste. So he says the security flaw actually allows him to see number of people who are sick in PMO, in army headquarters. So he can get the details of them. So a security issue has been found in the app is what he says. And he says privacy of 90 million Indians is at stake. He has asked the government to contact him in private. But the team of Arogya Setu gave a statement that no personal information of any user has proven to be at risk. So this is a response of the government to the ethical hacker's claim that no data or security breach has been identified. Then next is, poor find access to accounts hard. So this is a study which has been conducted to see whether COVID-19 relief scheme is benefiting people or not. So central government said 33 crore people have received cash benefits of ₹34,800 crore. Under the COVID-19 relief scheme. So they have this much amount has been transferred. So this has been transferred to bank accounts. But then survey says that rural households in six states, the survey was conducted, it was seen that rural households find difficulty in accessing bank accounts. So this is a concern being raised. So is of these 33 crore people, 22 crore are poor women who have received first installment of rupees 500 in their Jan Dhan bank accounts, indicating that means 98% of the target group is covered. Then 5.5 crore of these are said to have got the second installment as well. Then 3 crore are pensioners, 8.2 crore are farmers, 2.2 crore are construction workers, and 45 lakh salaried workers. They have also received benefit under the COVID-19 relief scheme, but this is benefit in their bank accounts. And some of these groups actually overlap also, and some of the funds are of prior existing benefits anyway. So they would be anyway getting those benefits, not a special benefit announced. And it was seen only 1/3 of the households who were surveyed were able to go to bank. So out of them also 80% would be able to successfully withdraw cash, and 1 out of 5 means returned without money even when they went to bank, because the bank was shut or the account showed zero balance. It is said only 5 respondents were able to access money outside the banks through ATMs, banking correspondents or customer service centers. So that percentage is very less. Everybody has to go to the bank. And only 23% of surveyed households said that they received rupees 500 in their Jan Dhan bank accounts. So 23% received an SMS notification about it. 33% did not get any money, and 40%, more than 40%, said that they did not know if the money had been received or not. Means they have not been intimated about anything. So this is there. However, the survey showed that food grain portion of the relief scheme is doing better. Has a better reach and is reaching the intended beneficiaries. 96% of surveyed households have received their ration for April 2020. So this is the figures which came out through the survey. Then next is fall in key treatment categories. So cardiology treatments offered under Ayushman Bharat have declined 45%. General surgery has come down 23%, and gynecology obstetrics related cases have gone down 25%. This is data from Feb to April. This is data which has come out from the official National Health Authority, which implements the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. The only category of treatment that has increased is that of general medicine. So the Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana offers health insurance to 10.74 crore poor rural families and identified occupational categories of even urban workers' families. So it's an annual health insurance of 5 lakh per family, and it covers medical and hospital expenses for several secondary and tertiary care procedures, and these can be accessed even at several private hospitals which are empaneled under the scheme. But presently the lockdown, private hospitals are shut down, and even government itself encourages people to visit hospitals only for essential treatments. So this is seen in the figures too. Now you can see how general surgery is down, medical oncology, cardiology, obstetrics, cardiothoracic surgeries are all down. Only general medicine, shown in red, has gone up. And this is the detail about Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, a cover of 5 lakh per family per year, number of families covered based on socioeconomic caste census, and there's no cap on family size or age. States are given flexibility to decide on mode of implementation as such too. So states are either through the states that will be implemented, and benefits are portable across the country. And was launched on 25th September, the birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. You can see the apex body implementing it is National Health Agency. There is no cap on family size or age to avail the scheme. So states have to join in. Some states had not joined in earlier but joined later. So many states have come on board now. Next is police arrest boy locker room group admin. So Delhi police's cyber cell has arrested the admin of Instagram group boy locker room. So this has been a group, Instagram group, created and used to share abusive messages and morphed images of underage girls on social media site. So 18-year-old admin of the group, who had appeared for class 12 board exam this year, has been arrested under this scheme, and other underage members of the group are being questioned. And lastly, you have European economy faces historic recession. So EU forecast a historic recession in the continent, European continent, which is battered by the deadly coronavirus pandemic. And Europe's biggest economy, Germany, has also unveiled plans for near return to normality, but manufacturing and car sales have been badly hampered. More than 60% drop in sales. So this is evident how the economy has been suffering, and lockdowns are tipping the world towards a recession not seen in decades. Also in Europe, it is UK which has highest number of deaths now, even more than Italy, and it is second in the world after US, which has highest number of deaths due to COVID-19. Europe accounts for a lion's share of deaths and infections overall, though, because many countries have been badly hit, like Britain, Italy, Spain and France. The Eurozone economy is now forecast by European EU Economic Affairs Commissioner to contract by an eye-watering 7.7%. Means it will be a minus 7.7% contraction. Not a growth, but contraction in the economy. So that is it. Thank you.